Captain Rajendran from BSc Medical Science Department, Amit University. I have sailed about 35 years at sea, joined in 1975 till 2012. I sailed various types of ships around the world, and presently I retired from the sea and joined as a associate professor in Amit University in June 2013. Today, dear cadets, today we are going to talk as all our mariners. Today we are going to talk about one of the most important topic, that is TRS, tropical rolling storm. As a mariner, this topic is very, very important for you. As you all aware that when storm comes, there will be it is a disastrous. We have to take actions. Storm doesn't come in a minute. Storm comes, it develops, it goes to 4 to 7 days. So today we are going to talk about the TRS. Briefly, I will tell you, because TRS is a very vast subject. But as a mariner, I am going to talk about briefly what is TRS, what is, how it is formed, what are the various effects. Today, just I am going to show some pictures about TRS. This is the general picture of TRS, which is taken by the satellite, and you can see the horizontal structure is about 300 to 500 kilometers, and the eye and inner wall. So we'll talk little bit elaborate in little later. The next slide also same TRS, you can see very clearly, which is forms near the Gulf of Mexico. Gulf of Mexico is one of the most prone area of TRS in the world. So that is TRS, which is approaching, which is formed near the West Africa, and it is coming towards east coast of America, that is for Gulf of Mexico. Next slide is very, very rare, because there are 3 TRS is formed. The one is formed at the Atlantic Ocean, other one at the Caribbean Sea, center one, the top one, the first one is the approaching the Florida, that is for Gulf of Mexico. This such a TRS is nothing, it's a storm. Such pictures you cannot see, it is very difficult to see, it doesn't happen. The 3 TRS which has happened somewhere else 2016 in the Gulf of Mexico, that is a picture. Generally you can see the TRS, what is the, see that Caribbean Sea and Bay of Bengal especially, nowadays TRS is a great danger shipping regardless where they are encountered and required a special study. So this is the area which is giving its just introduction of TRS. This is half semicircle. What you have seen the picture last 3 slides. What you have seen 3 slides, the TRS, that is the same which is in the half semicircle, which is talking about the horizontal as well as vertical. Normally TRS forms anticlockwise in the northern hemisphere and clockwise in the southern hemisphere. Dear cadets, the people always get confused. When I say about the hurricane, that about what is, I ask normally so many people during my second mate orals, what is hurricane, what is typhoon, what is cyclone? They all say different names. No, negative. All are same names. In different areas, different names. In Indian Ocean, it is called cyclone, where in India, where Burma, all Asian countries. In Pacific, it is called typhoon, and in Atlantic it is called hurricane, and Willy in Australia, Baguio in Philippines, and Typhoon in Japan. So So this is the same name of storms, tropical vs storms, in different areas, in different names. Please understand that. I asked so many times the people during my orals, the people confused. They say different name, negative. These all only same name in different areas. So I'm going to show generally the slide, 2-3 slides, where that cyclones is taking place, especially North Atlantic Ocean, South Atlantic Ocean, North Pacific, South Pacific, and Indian Ocean. You can see the slide, one or two places. But we'll see elaborately how the TRS is going to form. As we are in India, we are going to talk about the cyclone in Indian region, which you are more concerned. Look at the Arabian Sea during the change of monsoon. And mid-June, October, November, worst months of May, October, November, and Bay of Bengal, May to December. So, and this is the main cyclone happening in the Indian region. As I told you, TRS names are in different areas. Can you see here in the picture, which is the world map? You can see the hurricane in the Atlantic. But you may ask the question, why hurricane in the west coast of America, again hurricane, supposed to be in the Pacific. So it's supposed to be in typhoon. Negative because it is near America, that's why it is called always hurricanes. You see here in the Indian Ocean, where your Asian countries, it is called cyclones. Again, when you come to Pacific, this area Pacific, you got typhoon. So you can see the TRS is called in different names in different regions. Dear carrots, this slide shows how much TRS happening around the world approximately. Look at that, west coast of America and west coast of South America, normally it is almost 15 hurricanes happening in the year. About 12 in the Gulf of Mexico, which is formed West Africa and coming towards the most prone area is the Gulf of Mexico, where the Florida and the south coast and east coast of America is affected. And you can see South Indian Ocean about 12, about North Indian Ocean about 12, and you see, look at that Pacific, where the Japan, your Philippines, North China Sea, South China Sea, and East China Sea, where the one of the most prone area of TRS. That is giving ideas how much cyclone happening in a year approximately. Dear carrots, how the people ask me what is the difference between the depression, cyclone, severe cyclone, very severe cyclone. People not able to understand it. You must have heard during your whether regarding the forecast, they say there is a low pressure formed Bay of Bengal. Then after 2-3 days they will say depression is getting into deep depression. Then later they say cyclone formed. How? This all depends upon the wind speed. That is, we must be able to understand. As per the wind speed only, this all the terms being called. First of all, till 13 up to 17 knots, normally it's called low pressure area. When the wind speeds, you take example of Bay of Bengal, the wind speeds up to 70 knots, they say there is a low pressure formed. Low pressure area formed near the Bay of Bengal, about 200 kilometer away from the in Chennai, or it is between Andaman and Sumatra, whatever they say. Later, 1 or 2 days, there are 6 factors which is required for the cyclone to form, which I am going to discuss later. So according that wind speed, when it goes to 17 to 27, it is called depression. When the wind speed goes to 27 to 33, it is called deep depression. From 34 to 47, it is called cyclone. So when the wind speed exceeds more than 34 knots, then only cyclone, they say cyclone formed, and they give the names. Cyclone name, and they will tell you it is formed, it is going to affect the east coast, especially Paradip or Chennai or Nagapattinam or Calcutta, whatever it is. Then when the wind speed goes to 48 to 63, it is called severe cyclone. Then when it is going to 64 to 119, it is called super cyclone. When it is exceeding 120, it is called one super cyclone. So you can see the slide is very clearly is given. So low pressure area up to 17 knots and depression 17 to 27 knots, deep depression about to 28 to 33, and cyclones 34 to 47, and severe cyclone 48 to 63, and very severe cyclone 64 to 119, and above 119 it is called super cyclone. For your kind information, there is no super cyclone hit India. The last cyclone which hit India in 21st century, that is 1999, Orissa, where the wind speed goes to more than 230 kilometers, where more than 220,000 people died. There are billions of crores of rupees been affected. Normally in India they say knots, because but when you go to come to USA hurricane and all, they say is a kilometer. That's what you can see this slide, what it says. This is called Saffir-Simpson scale, where the hurricane, they don't say it is a depression, deep depression, cyclone, severe cyclone, very severe cyclone and super cyclone. They say category 1, category 2, category 3, category 4 and category 5, which is affected especially the Gulf of Mexico, that is where Florida, east coast of America. You can see the simple, look at that. What is the wind speed in kilometer per hour, that meter per hour, miles per hour, and storm surge. Storm surge is nothing, it is a wave height. Because of the wind speed, the wave height goes. So this slide shows the general idea about the Saffir-Simpson scale. Saffir-Simpson scale, which is used by the American, USA, United States of America, in the hurricane areas. This slide is talking about the normal general category. What I explained to you the previous slide, what is category 1 and category 2, category 3, category 4 and category 5. Category 5 is nothing, it is a super cyclone. Catastrophic, extreme, extensive, moderate and minimal. They are giving a simple ideas, what is the category 1, category 2, category 3, category 4 and category 5. And you can see the pictures in the satellite pictures. That one another 2-3 slides which I am going to show, that normally how the, why the high cyclone is happening. Just you can see the general, simple, central idea how the tier is forming. The first slide is showing the, because of the heat. Look at the second slide, same, because of the heat and because of the Coriolis forces, the tier is forming. The next slide is showing about the, normally the cyclone forms between 5 to 20 degrees in northern hemisphere as well as southern hemisphere. It never forms between 5 degree north and 5 degree south. Why? That we will see in the later stages. Now I am going to the one of the most important points, how TRS forms, what all the various conditions required. This is one of the most important, where I ask normally when I go for the borals, MM borals, normally any interview I ask that students how TRS forms. People not aware of that. Mainly there are 6 conditions to fulfill, then only all the 6 conditions are fulfilled, then only TRS forms. Otherwise if the one of the conditions not meeting, then TRS will not form. So now we are going to discuss about the all the 6 points where the TRS forms. Number 1, you can see the sea surface temperature should be 27 degree centigrade or 18 degree Fahrenheit, and the seawater depth should be minimum 60 meters. Because of that seawater temperature, the high evaporation taking place. So one of the high evaporation is required for the TRS. Number 2 is a fair amount of Coriolis forces. As you all know that our earth is rotating at a speed of 1667 kilometers per hour. At the same time, it is orbiting around the sun at the speed of 108,000 kilometers. It is unimaginable. You go just in bike 100 kilometers, but you know what is the effect of the wind. The same, we are rotating at the speed of 1667 kilometer. We are just rotating at the same time we are orbiting around the sun. Our speed of the earth is 108,000 kilometer per hour. Because of the what is happening, there is a Coriolis forces which is happening. The Coriolis, because of Coriolis forces, the Coriolis forces always negligible at the equator, because it is a sine theta. Sine theta 0 equal to 0. So when sine 90 is equal to 1, that's why the Coriolis forces are one of the powerful force which is affecting the to form TRS. That's why it is negligible near the equator when it go higher. That's why you can see the last previous slide I have shown you, the TRS never forms between 5 degrees south and 5 degrees north. means almost near the equator, the TRS never form because it is a Coriolis forces not at all there. The third is low pressure area surrounded the high pressure area. The low pressure area surrounded by the high pressure area is the third point, because then only when the high pressure area is there, the wind blows. As you all aware that wind always blows from high pressure area to low pressure area. So when the low pressure area is out there, let's suppose the example it is 100 millibars and high pressure area about 135. What happens? That all the air, because it is a vacuum, the 1000 millibar is a low, so there is a vacuum created there. So surrounding the all the air will try to fill up the low pressure area. So the low pressure area surrounded by high pressure area is also required for the TRS. Fourth point is a convectional current. Convectional current is always one of the most important factors. Convectional current because of the large island areas. Normally, I ask the students, you see, why the TRS, the cyclone is always happening in the east coast of India? You see, always happening in the Chennai, Vaisak, Paradip, Calcutta, Nagapattinam, or Sri Lanka. Why it doesn't happen maximum in the Arabian Sea? Arabian Sea will not see. Have you ever seen that Bombay hit by cyclone or Cochin hit by cyclone? Never happened. Why? This is the reason. Because there is Andaman Islands, Sumatra Island, there are large land areas there. Because of land, high evaporation taking place, the land surrounded by the water where the convectional current is taking place, the air is moving upwards, the heat is then later, because the heat is one of the source required for the cyclone. That's why we get always TRS cyclone happening in the east coast of India, not in the west coast of India. Now you may be understanding that. Next, the fifth point is the weak prevailing winds. Weak prevailing means you see, the cyclone always doesn't happen. Cyclone, what is happening cyclone? Cyclone, to form a cyclone, we require the vertical height. When weak winds are there, the wind will be carried horizontally. It doesn't move vertically. That's why the cyclone never happens. You see that southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon, which is happening in India. Southwest monsoon starts somewhere else, May, June, July, August. And your northeast monsoon starts about October, November and December. So you see that TRS which is happening, it is always happening that before southwest monsoon or after southwest monsoon, and before northeast monsoon or after southeast monsoon. Why? Because that time only the weak winds are there. Because the weak winds, the winds will be carried only urgently. The strong winds are there, because the monsoon, during monsoon the winds are very strong, which will not allow the winds to lift up vertically. That's why always it happens in the during the before monsoon or after monsoon of India. Just example. Last point is the high humidity. You know high humidity means moisture content should be more. You have a high humidity means 80% and 90% moisture is there. That's why you see during the TRS, during the cyclone, before 3 days, 4 days, heavy rain, because of the high moisture, nothing else. Because you all knows that, because now we are discussing about all the 6 points, that this TRS always form in the ocean, it never form in the land, always form in the ocean. Why? Because the humidity is one of the major forces. That's why you look at that hurricane which is hitting the Gulf of Mexico, it is normally originated from the West Africa. It is almost and traveling almost 2000 to 3000 kilometer throughout the Atlantic and hitting the America, that is your North America. Because at the same time, when it traveling 2000 kilometers means it is observing lot of moisture. That's why it is heavily rain, the rain 2 days, 3 days, 7 days, 5 days, because of the high humidity. So now we all will be understanding this, all the 6 points. One of the condition is not met, then TRS will not form. So again, I will brief you. Number one is your seawater temperature should be 27 degree. And sea survey, the depth should be minimum 60 meter. Number two, Coriolis forces. Number three is where low pressure area surrounded high pressure area. Number four, weak prevailing winds. Number five is where humidity. Number six is where. So now we discuss about the 6 points. Number one is where seawater temperature. Number two is where Coriolis forces. Number three is where low pressure area. Number four is a convectional current. Number five is a weak prevailing winds. Number six is humidity. Where you can see, look at that, picture. The picture shows how the TRS is forming. All the 6 points are met with the PowerPoint. This picture also same telling the all the 6 points where the TRS is required, 6 conditions. At the same time, it is showing the how the look at that picture, which is showing that which is happening in the. This all taken by the NASA satellite, which has hit the USA. You can see the horizontal structure and vertical structure of the satellite pictures. And can you see the down by other picture, which is showing the all that which is forming near the Africa and it is moving. There are 4 stages are there to form a cyclone. Number 1 is called formation. Number two is very immature. The 3rd is called formature. The 4th is called decaying. There are 4 stages which is happening here: formation, and your immature, and mature, and your decaying stage. The 4 stages. Okay. Now we are going to see how normally the TRS is taking place in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Normally you look at that is the equator, and there is always. The both hemisphere is formed from east to west. In northern, first of all, I'll show you the northern hemisphere. It is moving from east to west and slowly taking the northwest direction, northerly, and which ending with the northeast. This is northern hemisphere. This is southern hemisphere. Southern hemisphere same. Southern hemisphere, what is happening? This moves from east to west and move towards southerly and end with the southeasterly. This is that. General track of TRS in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Normally, the TRS happening anti-clockwise in northern hemisphere and clockwise in the southern hemisphere. So normally the TRS happening between 3 to 4 to 7 days, what you can see, and it happens always 5 to 20 degrees towards north and south. So we are going to discuss about that. As I told you, that normal generally I will talk about the how the TRS is forming. I told you already earlier, there are 4 stages. Number 1 is called formation stage, 2nd is the immature stage, 3rd one is the matured stage, and the 4th one is the decaying stage. The first stage is the formation stage, where there, as I told you, what is the formation stage? Formation stage is nothing, all the 6 conditions or 6 factors fulfilling the criteria to form TRS. That is where, again recapping, that is your seawater temperature should be 27 degree and your Coriolis forces. Number 3 is your low pressure area surrounded by high pressure area. Number 4, convectional current. Number 5, pre-weak winds, and number 6 is your humidity. So that is the, when all the 6 factors fulfilled, all the 6 conditions are met, then there is a TRS forms. That is called formation stage. Number 2 is your immature stage. Immature stage, which is getting into that, because of the all low pressure area surrounded by high pressure area, all the winds which is surrounding nearby coming, and it's called meeting there, and you look at that, the spiral is taking place. That's why the TRS, you see the TRS always, it will be rotating in the anti-clockwise direction in the northern hemisphere and clockwise in the southern hemisphere, where the spiral movement is taking place in the immature stage. This is called the picture which is showing that the 2nd stage, which is your immature stage. Look at that, how it is taking, the spiral condition taking place. See that, look at that, this, because of the Coriolis forces, it taking spiral actions and moving, because of that the cold air which is ascending down, and your warm air is rising up, and because the wind travels, that's why the horizontal and vertical both are developing further. Because the wind, the TRS is forming almost 300 to 500 kilometer horizontally, as well as 0 to about 12 kilometer vertically, which the switcher shows you. This shows normally the general, what I told you, that 4 stages. Can you see the down one, the subtropical ridge, where the formation taking place? Where the formation taking place, look at that, this is the West Africa near the Cape de Verde, which is taking the formation. Slowly it's moving towards westerly, and it is taking the immature stage. Slowly you look at that, the spiral accident are taking place. The 3rd one, look at that, this is called the formation stage, which I am going to explain you later, and it is a is a formation, this is immature, and this is a mature stage. And the, look at the mature stage, which is well developed with TRS and moving towards the Caribbean Sea and going towards the Gulf of Mexico, especially the west coast of east coast of America, that is where Florida area. So the slide shows about the mature stage, the third stage. First one is a formation, second is a immature, third one is a mature stage, where it is a fully developed, because it's observed all the six conditions and it become very well strengthened, depends upon the speed. That's why the wind speed, it is well developed, means that's what I told you, cyclone, severe cyclone, super cyclone, very severe cyclone and super cyclone. Like that, that is called the mature stage, how it is gathering and collecting the various characteristics, according to that it will develop further and further. The fourth one is the last stage, dissipating stage. When you see the dissipating stage, normally the cyclone, as I told you earlier, the cyclone always forms in the ocean and goes towards the land. As soon as it touches the land, it is automatically weakened. Why? Because number one, the main source of the humidity being cut off, because it's observing a lot of moisture in the oceans. And as soon as it touches the land, heavy rain, the moisture is cut off. Number two, because of the frictional forces, because of land, there is obstruction. That's why it is always weakening at the land. That last stage is the decaying stage or finishing stage of TRS. The corrosion stresses, again, is a 3 point. Number one is eye. You must have seen the previously when I shown the always eye is created. I told you eye, inner wall or outer ring. So the three is a part of the corrosion structure. The picture clearly shows about the eye is about a 10 to 30 kilometer is a eye. Again, wall, inner ring or wall, eye wall is about 30 to 50 kilometers. And outer wall is, or outer wing is 50 to 200 kilometer or 300 kilometer or 400 kilometer, is depends upon the how the cyclone, whether it is a cyclone or severe cyclone or very severe cyclone or super cyclone, according that the horizontal structure keep on vary. So look at this picture which I shown you. Again, when I shown the diagram, this is the one normal, the satellite picture of the TRS. It can clearly seen what is I, which is about 10 to 30 kilometers, was your inner wall is your 30 to 50 kilometer, and outer wall 50 to 200 kilometer or 300-400, depends upon the strength of the TRS. This is a satellite picture. You can see in the PowerPoint the normal structure of the horizontal structure of the TRS. Again, I asked one of the question to the second mates, especially when I come for the oral, why the eye is safe or not? The people say, no sir, the TRS is not all safe. Some people say I is safe. Then I ask them, why I is safe? But most of the cadets not able to reply, why I is safe? There are some random reasons are there, why I is safe. As I told you, the horizon structure, I is 10 to 30 kilometers. So what is happening in the eye? I is one of the safest place. Why? Because number one, what is the reason? Look at that picture, where is the eye? Eye is a big hollow portion. Number one, because of the strong surface winds, which is not reaching the towards the center. Why? The strong surface wind doesn't reach the center. Why it doesn't reach? Because of the centrifugal force. There are, you know, you must have studied during your plus 2, 10th standard, 9th standard, there are two forces acting. One is called centripetal and other one is centrifugal. Centripetal, which is throwing out, and centrifugal, which is attracting. Because of centrifugal force, which is that the air is thrown out, which is not reaching the center. That's why the number one, eye is always calm. Number two, because of the Coriolis forces, as I told you, Coriolis forces also one of the requirement of the TRS. Because the Coriolis forces, the wind always doesn't go straight, it deflects. Because the deflection, there is a big hollow portion being created. Number three, the temperature in the eye always higher than the surrounding. Why? Because, as I told you, this because of centrifugal force, the wind being thrown out, there is a vacuum created. Because the vacuum, the temperature is shooting up. Because the temperature is dry, because of that no air is not there, because dry, that's why the eye region always temperature is about 5 degree more than the surrounding. Suppose example, the outer side is that 34 degree, then eye will be, the temperature will be 39 degree or 40 degree. So approximately 5 degree more than the surrounding. Now we discuss about the horizontal structure, that is your eye, inner wall and outer wall. Now we are going to discuss about the vertical structure. Vertical structure, normally it is about 0 to 12 kilometers height, As I told you very clearly, because of the weak prevailing winds, the wind blow goes upwards. The because of the evaporation, high evaporation, the wind goes upwards and it goes up to 12 kilometer height. That is what the picture shows about the vertical structure. Same like a horizontal structure, eye, inner ring and outer wall. Same thing here in the vertical structure also. Three stages are there that we'll discuss in the next slide. Vertical structure, as I told you, it is about 0 to 12 kilometer. The first stage is called inflow layer. That is, which is you can see up to, you can see the, about 2 to 3 kilometers is your inflow layer, the first layer, first vertical. The second stage is called mid tropospheric layer, which is about 3 to 8 kilometer. The second stage from 3 kilometer to 8 kilometer vertically. The fourth stage is called outer flow layer, which is about to 8 to 12 kilometer. The three structures is the normal vertical structure. Now we are going to next class, we are going to discuss about the various other factors, that is where how the tear is forming, what are the various conditions, what are the various forecasts, what is the track, what are the various types of TRS, what are the various parameters required for the TRS, and still I am going to develop about the horizontal and vertical stage. You all understand, I think it is a very interesting topic. I think you people will be enjoyed with the topic. Thanks.